Hi and welcome to my watercolour tutorial. My name is Rebecca Jarman and I'm going to go through a workshop with you today on how to paint a zebra. These are the materials we'll be using. So you need to have one pot of water for cleaning your brush, preferably a large one. One pot of water for mixing colours that we keep clean. Some paper towel for cleaning your brush on. Some tape. I've got masking tape here, which is sort of low tack and it doesn't tear your paper when you use it. So we're going to use the tape to stick our paper down to the board. The watercolour set that you've been given by the art group. I'm going to use two paint brushes. One's a sort of a larger round brush, it's a number 10, and then a smaller round brush with a point is a number 6. You'll also need a pencil, a HB one is fine, and if you have one, a graphite stick. If you don't have a graphite stick, then that's fine too, you can just use your pencil. You will also need some watercolour paper, which is here. So let me just organise my things here. So I am using the Aquafine Darla and Rowney paper. It's got a slight texture on it and it's cold pressed. And it's 300 grams, which is quite important. So the thicker the watercolour paper, the better quality it is. And the less likely it is to buckle, which is when you get these mounds and troughs when you add water to the page. So I will be using that. You'll also need your image. So if you print off your image beforehand, and this is what we use to transfer the picture to the paper. And you might also want to use a board of some kind to attach your paper to. To begin with, we need to secure our watercolour paper to the board. So taking your masking tape, you want to tear off lengths of tape that are slightly longer than your sides of the paper so that they overlap, and I usually do it so that there's 50% on the paper, 50% on the board, so it really secures it well. So we secure all four edges. Press down nice and firm. And to transfer this to the paper, you need to turn your piece over and taking either your pencil or your graphite stick, and you want to scribble across the back of the picture, making sure that you cover all of that image. Using your pencil, it's exactly the same, but it will take a lot longer to do. You just want to give it a nice even coat of graphite. just takes you a little bit longer to do using a pencil. So now we have the graphite on the back of your printout, we're going to transfer this picture onto our watercolour paper so that we can start our painting. So taking your HB pencil, make sure that it's got a bit of a point on it. You don't want to be using a blunt pencil because you'll get very fat lines. And when it comes to some of these details, you want to make sure you've got fine lines. So what you want to do is start at the top of your drawing and you just want to press your pencil and draw around the outside edges of your picture. So you're just doing an outline of the shape. Now take your time on this, it's really important that you get it right. You don't want to spend just a couple of minutes doing this. You want to really make sure that all the shapes are correct, and it's important when you're doing animals or people that you get everything in proportion, because it would be quite clear if you get it wrong. So I'm just following the side of his face here. My pencil. And now I'm going to draw in some of the detail. The side of his nose. His nostril. Then I want to make sure I've got his eyelashes in there. It's really important to get the eyes right. And just take your time around those areas. And draw in the little highlight that you see there as well. And then the pattern that's underneath it. And just carry on in that way. I'm going to draw all the shapes of the stripes, the markings. I'm going to draw each one of those in as well. Once you have completed transferring all those lines to your paper, we can remove that reference sheet from your paper. So I used a little bit of sticky tape just to hold it in place. And set your image to one side, because you're going to want to refer to that while you're painting. And as you can see, I have lots of lines now that I can follow while I'm painting. So now we have our image nicely on our paper here, ready to begin painting. If you've done the colour mixing with me before you started this, you will have produced two colour wheels, a warm colour wheel and a cool colour wheel. It'll be really helpful to have these to hand while you produce this painting. So if you have them to one side with your image, you can refer to these as we go along. Because what I want to do is, rather than producing a simple black and white zebra, as everybody would expect, we're going to make it a little bit more funky and bright and add a lot of other colours into the mix. So if we can refer to those colour wheels, that will be really useful. Okay, so if you set out your materials, you're going to want your, if you're right-handed, you're going to want your paper on the left-hand side and your palette and paints on the right. You also want your water on the right-hand side as well, and your brushes to hand. And then if you put your colour wheel and your reference image on your left-hand side, that's quite close, so we can keep an eye on that too. This way, you're not going crossing the water across your painting like this. You're not going to splash and spoil your work as you're going.